Welcome back to the program on this interview segment. Now, joining me is Esther Nema, who is an entrepreneur. Esther, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
Now, tell us something about yourself first.
My name is Esther Nema. I am a journalist, actress, editor at the moment. I'm editing. I work for iFlix, Kenya, as an editor, subtitle editor. Then I'm an entrepreneur. I've been since 2013 until now, doing various kinds of projects, starting and initiating different kinds of projects. And so, once an entrepreneur, always.
You seem to be wearing lots of hats. Tell us about your entrepreneurship hat.
My entrepreneurship. Well, I started entrepreneuring at it just 2 years after school, when I'd worked for a while. And then one time I just finished one contract, was over, and I thought, what do I want to do? Because then I was a presenter, and not fully like a full-time presenter, it was as just doing shows. So I had a lot of time in my hands, and I said, what can I do with the much time that I have in my hands? And I started thinking and exploring different types of, you know, things that I could do. Then it started being a path that I really, really wanted to do. Like, that's all I wanted
after
to do.
After lots of thoughts.
Yes. Okay. I wanted to now be an entrepreneur. I wanted to start entrepreneurship. And at that moment, it wasn't out of a purpose or a cause that I wanted to really support, but it was because entrepreneurship was the in thing to do at that moment. And like, every amazing person is an entrepreneur, so you want
every
to
young
be,
person is an entrepreneur. To be successful, you have to be an entrepreneur.
Exactly, yeah. And everyone is like, all millionaires, all these people who are at the top, they're all entrepreneurs. And so you're like, you want to do it, you want your name somewhere on it.
Okay.
So yeah, but it's been a great journey.
So what are you working on now?
At the moment, I'm working on content. We formed a network of people in different areas, especially in production. People that entail to creating content, say the producers, the writers, the actors, the presenters, who would have otherwise not had, you know, a team. We are creating that team for ourselves. And I think it's the most amazing thing, where now we come together and we're like, you know what, I can't survive on my own. Even if,
so what's basically the name of the team that you've created?
Empire Content Network.
Empire Content Network.
Empire Content Network.
So how big is the team so far?
At the moment, we are about 15 that we can speak of, the ones that are on board and know what's happening and what we're doing. But we envision probably a time when we'll be 100, 1,000. That's our vision, to have as many people
as possible.
Yeah, as possible.
So the 15, are you only all of you in Nairobi, or some are outside Nairobi?
Nairobi. I think we are starting with our locality at the moment, where we are at the moment. Hopefully we will traverse through places and different places, because there's no limit to this country, but our projects will not be limited to here. We want to go as far wide as
beyond
the entire
borders.
Kenya, yeah, because equally these needs are not just here, but actually across the board. Many young people are looking for a team to come together and do work together here.
So the 15 of you, how did you meet? Is it through referrals or through the social media, or went to an event? How did you meet?
What happens is, in life you meet people. Like, I'm sure probably if you've gone through the entrepreneurship journey, like, you're constantly looking for partners or people you've worked with forever, right? But, and you always imagine that it's far-fetched from people that you already know. Strange thing, all of us are connected in one way to one person, yeah? Like, some of them went to school in Daystar. Some of them, we went to school in primary. Like, two of them were my classmates in primary.
So they're basically some people you've known previously.
Yeah, we've known previously. So it's to realize, but we've had this conversation of what can we do together. So let's say I had this conversation with you at one point in 2011, and we forgot about it. And they had the same conversation with another person in 2008, and then we all come together and we're like, you know what, we've talked about it separately, how about we come together, all of us, and now actually do it, you know, action. You know how you have that resolution,
you
know, like,
actualize
it's time for action.
It.
Yeah.
Now Empire Content.
Yeah.
So far, what maybe have you worked on?
At the moment, we've just shot. We've shot a production, our first production.
Is it a film or something?
No, it's a talk show.
A talk show.
It's a talk show having conversation, truth conversation called Ukweli Wangu, which hopefully we should be launching in February or
March. That's next month, huh?
Yeah, next month or the other, we hope to now launch. So we've just shot, we gathered and we did probably like 7 to 10 episodes for a start. And then probably now in March we do now the second season. So we're really excited.
I hope I'll be invited for the launch.
Yeah, you should, yeah. We want to do a party for you to just launch and just go out there by.
So now that you've already worked on a first project,
yeah.
What were some of the challenges maybe you went through
when doing that project?
Yeah, because you know, for many entrepreneurs, they normally, as you say rightly, yeah. many of them just say that the biggest challenge is capital.
Yeah, it is actually. But initially, it was money. But I feel like when you have a great idea, and people are excited about it, and people are passionate, like there's nothing that beats passion and nothing beats drive. Like you're so passionate about something, you want to see it happen. So we'd come, say, on set, and probably it's one of those days. We don't have much. Yeah. We just have our ideas and our dreams, and we're all coming back knowing that each of us has nothing. But we're coming on board because we want to make this happen. So we pulled it off somehow. We managed to secure a very good location, which is so good and amazing. VIP status.
Wow.
Yeah. We managed to pull over and get, you know, like one of us already had equipment. Had already had an
yeah. In fact, I was coming
suit.
To that because you see, in production, the equipment cost is quite high, and also hiring it is also expensive.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, but you see, what someone says the beauty of leverage is one person has this, like someone has equipment, but they don't have a team. Your problem is you have a great idea, but you don't have equipment.
Or you have the skill and you don't have the equipment to operate.
Yes, exactly. Or you have. We all have something, but we are all lacking something. So how can we all collaborate and come up with something that, you know, we meet each other's needs? So then it's not a point where now me as a presenter or me as an actor is coming and asking you for money. I know that I'm building my portfolio, you're also building your portfolio. We've come together because it's now not a time where now we say I'm using you to build my portfolio. All of us are growing, so we are all like sort of
complementing each other.
Yeah. Then other people have other problems. They have money, but they don't have ideas.
No skill at all.
No talent whatsoever.
But lots
you
of
have money.
Yeah.
So I'm like, if your problem is money and how to use it, then why don't you come on board and let's show you how we can use it and how can we make it together? Because I think a time is coming where we don't want to be people of word. We want to be people of action. That is, I'm saying, I'm helping you. We are helping each other.
Then still on matters money, maybe in your venture now, have you gotten somebody who can come in and pump maybe some capital into Empire?
Yeah, we've had conversations with people who have been there, like who've done that. And so for them, the issue of money is not really an issue. Like if we do need money, for which we've realized actually when you have all this, you don't need capital is just an excuse a lot of times. Usually when you have something great and you really, really want it, you'll find all ways to do it. Yeah. So when we do, and sometimes we usually do, say for example, we needed to hire lights and sound because we didn't already have. But we're hoping eventually we'll have people who have lights and sound on their own. So they come and they want to be the greatest light directors in Africa and they want a team. We'll want such type of arrangements whereby we come as freely with as minimal cost as possible. But we have had like people who are interested in investing and being part of the project.
Now that you already have the content, you maneuvered some of the challenges, and you're saying that you'll be launching your first project latest by March this year.
Yeah.
You already have a market for that content where you're going to sell, because now you know with the digitalization we realize there's so many TV stations. But they're just playing music, 80% music, no content.
Yeah. Well, that's one thing. I think we had that conversation of where do we want to take our content?
Yeah.
Is it online? Is it on traditional media? And we're open to as much, you know, as much space as possible. Because I understand one of the greatest challenges for most media houses is to buy this content because it's pricey. But because we'll have produced it at very little cost, we've just brought in our effort. Eventually, though, we do want to earn. We want to distribute it to as many avenues as possible. That way, it's not so expensive for one production house to buy it because it's widely distributed. Yeah. And so, so we are looking into all the stations, possibly traditional as well as the modern online, which is available.
Yeah.
And we always say, if worse comes to us, so we can go YouTube. People are making off a lot
from
of money
viewership,
from viewership on YouTube,
okay,
because we are very sure about the product that we are putting in together, and we are very sure about the team that we've brought in together. These are people who you meet them and instantly your heart feels,
yeah,
it's in there. They're people full of energy and life, and we're having conversations that are about what we went through, the young people, because the show is called Ukweli Wangu. It's our truth. What is our truth? Yeah, we're having these conversations. We're having young people committing suicide every day because they feel they're alone, they're lost, they're unemployed, they're without opportunity, and we're coming on board and we're saying, you can hack it. If you're fired, you can do
There's
it, man.
Still a way.
There's still a way. It's not the end of life. You have a chance to still grow yourself. Yeah.
Then also now, you're a graduate from this university.
Yeah.
You said public relations.
Yes, public relations. Yeah.
Now, when you completed school, did you see yourself venturing into this? Or you are also looking like, after graduation, you'll be some senior manager somewhere in a blue chip company?
Yeah.
Did you see yourself here?
Yeah, no. It never occurred to me. Entrepreneurship. In fact, I don't think I ever thought I'll do business or trade. It never occurred to me until one day my dad was saying, "No, the future is entrepreneurship." But you see, of course, even as you graduate, your parents assume that you're naturally good, because don't only your parents
get a big job,
think you're amazing.
Yeah.
You know, they think you're amazing until you realize the world is full of amazing people. Like people who are talented and skilled, and it's very competitive. So in as much as, yes, you start with energy, because for me personally, I wanted to be the government spokesman of the country, because that was public relations.
By then, who was the government spokesperson?
Mutua.
Mutua, Machakos governor.
Yes.
So
yes.
I wanted to take his job.
I found him so fascinating. And so that's what I wanted to do.
Okay.
But even slowly, as I was just graduating, I started being very interested in media. And so I started then pursuing presenting opportunities, which I eventually did, and that's how I managed to have so much time in my hands. But it comes to a time now when I had so much time, and my dad was like, entrepreneurship is the way to go.
Mm-hmm.
And he had done a master's in entrepreneurship. And so he's like, great things are made by people who start things, who innovate. So he triggered that interest. And so when my contract was ending from a certain place, and I was getting this other presenting job which would engage me very minimally, I started looking at it as an option, and I wanted to do it. And the things that I said, what do I like to do? What did I want to give my employer? And then how can I do it on my own?
Mm.
And so I came up with crazy ideas. Like I came up, and most of them for me, like my first company, which was Bell Enterprise Team Events, I just started as a joke, and I thought about it. I was in a neighborhood that's really isolated, and I thought, what if we had events and parties?
Themed events.
Yeah, themed events. What if we had festivals? You know, things that you've seen in movies. And I'm like, this place is so dull and quiet. Somewhere along Kilimani. It's dull and quiet. We're all in the house. What if we created events whereby we can all meet each other?
Bring out
like
the entire neighborhood. Come,
yeah.
Let's celebrate.
Exactly. Yeah, you create festivity.
Okay.
Like even
That's
the
good.
Old African culture, it was all about festivity. Yeah, people met.
Mm.
So it's like now we're having challenges. Men are not meeting women. They don't know where to find
people
them.
Are going on social media to meet.
People, yeah, they are poking others. And I'm
waving through
waving.
Facebook.
I know. Someone
but
had
not talking.
Waves
literally
100
not.
Times.
Yeah.
How can we create platforms where people can meet, socialize, interact, and make this a lifestyle? Like, you don't need to be depressed because we have events. But I think I was at a phase where I was all about happiness, and which I think I am.
Yeah.
And that was the original idea. So I did my first event, which was the launch and then the Valentine's event.
Okay, now through your education, do you think because you realize many graduates are unemployed, many are frustrated, they can't get the dream jobs of the graduation, and now you get out of school and you're now pushed, you're being told now, the opportunities are rare, you go into entrepreneurship,
yeah.
start your own business, start yeah. your own company, apply for tenders. Do you think the current education system really prepares one to be an entrepreneur, or you just have to get in there, swim through and the sharks and find your way out?
Well, I feel it should be incorporated into the education system, because it's not as easy. It looks like it's very easy, but God knows, entrepreneurship is like half of it. You're really broke. Living below the poverty line.
Listening to most entrepreneurs,
you
listen to their story, you think like it's just a click of a finger and they made it there.
No, it's not. Because a lot of times you're not aware. Because you have all this time.
Yeah.
You have all this energy, but you're not directed. You don't have a focus. You're going nowhere. Like you feel you're busy, and you're literally working on something literally every day. But you're really going nowhere.
Mm.
You know, you're just like you're going into like a straight path that's leading to almost nowhere. And every day you're guessing and you're struggling. However, entrepreneurship is not really like an option or a choice, because where we're heading, employment. We need to be, especially if you have a degree, you need to be the people who come up with these brilliant ideas.
And be the job creators.
Yeah. So we cannot equally be the problem, you know. So yes, you're thrown into the deep end, but you come up with solutions. Like what I believe, I personally, the greatest lessons I learned is because I took that risk of entrepreneurship. And I cannot say, of course, it would be great that if the education system needs to put it into the curriculum.
So that you come out trained, ready. Yeah. You know.
So that a year down the road or 2 years down the road and you're not getting a job, suicide is the last option in your mind. Because you see a lot of people are frustrated. You know, some of us maybe, we are so strong.
Young
like
people
it would
today
never
have
come
answers because
yeah.
of
answers.
Thinking
or high
so
blood
much.
Pressure
yeah.
at 24.
Mm.
But if you tell someone that you have the solution to getting out of there, whatever it is that you are going to offer your employer, and you write on your CV, you can do it.
Mm.
You really should be able to do it.
Okay.
And so, yeah. So I think, yeah, even I learned all skills I never had.
You never had
things like that. Yeah.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah. But it would be great if we could incorporate it into the system. However, I know so many people who made it, and they went through these systems, and they didn't. No one taught them. Like a lot of stuff you learn in life is not from class. It's the self-taught.
So you're saying that you also, other than education, you also be willing to learn new skills.
Yeah, get mentors, learn things that you didn't know before. And you'd be very surprised with every step. Because now what happened after I started this second initiative, it's so different from what I went through the first round. It's so different and more faster. Yeah.
Now, Esther, I want you to look straight to that camera.
Yeah.
And encourage a graduate, probably someone who is a graduate from university, maybe frustrated, has not landed his dream job. Just tell them something.
Okay, well, I know as a graduate, you go through quite a lot. First of all, because you believe you've worked so hard. You really worked so hard and you deserve, you know, a space. But truth is, when you come out here, everyone is amazing, everyone is brilliant, and you meet, it's very competitive. And not that you won't eventually get a dream job, because right now I'm working and at a place that I really, really love. But you can't wait for that moment. If that moment is not already there, you create that moment. And you must believe that within you is the gut and the ability to create whatever it is that you imagine. And believe me, one thing that my dad taught me, when I was really struggling and trying to find my way, is like the people who go through this, some of these toughest moments in terms of finding their way, even the people that probably he met before in his life, eventually when you look, they start this very tough entrepreneurial journey and persist. They're the people who now actually, they're the who owns Kenya. Like eventually you do make it. And so keep trying, keep striving. Never let a day pass with you doing nothing. So as you wait for employment, or if you don't choose it at all, because entrepreneurship is a great cause. You're being called to creating opportunities not only for yourself, but actually for everyone. So it's a great path to go by. And so, yeah, just be bold and take it and go grab the world by...
Thank you, Esther, for all that.
By the
now,
hand.
That was Esther Nema, an entrepreneur from Empire Content and also at Bella Enterprise themed events. Now, that's all what you had for you on this week's edition of Business Tuesday. My name is Eddie Nyadwa. Stay tuned on LTN.